Avaes Mohammed, his writing was really born out of a sense of political necessity. That's one of the things that really drew me to his work in the first place. He said that he wrote his first poem following the Oldham riots in 2001, and he continues in his practice to constantly tackle some of the really toughest issues, in social issues around identity, exclusion, imperialism, political violence, and a sense of belonging. I started writing poetry, performing poetry, looking back, as a means of trying to stay sane within myself with all the lies around me, he once said. But his work not only represents political conflict, it also actually intervenes and tries to help to resolve it. And I think that's really impressive. He's done a huge amount of work with English Pen, with the Bhopal Medical Appeal, and he's run lots of creative workshops within the community, trying to tackle artistically some of the issues that his poetic theater addresses. So for example, he ran performance workshops for Muslim and Jewish theater makers. He's done workshops with young people in the north of England as part of this really interesting diptych play that he wrote, Throwing Rubble at the Sun and Throwing Rubble at the Moon. And there are two plays which address Muslim terrorism and white fascism diptych way. So he counts, he says, among his influences, Sufi saints and Jamaican dub poets. And his work is not only crossing geographic and political boundaries, but also generic ones between theater, spoken word, film, radio, and even puppetry. He said, I was going to be a scientist, but since 9/11, I felt I had no option but to write. I do it because this is my home and I want to make it a better place. Please welcome Avaes.
Depending on the introduction, it's about my life. It's a real pleasure to be here tonight. It's such a beautiful space and such beautiful poems that we've heard already. Thank you very much. It's a joy to be sharing space with you all. So I'm going to read some poems, and I always start with voices. So we'll start again with voices. Voices speak and so I hear. Voices call and I draw near. Voices deep within my chest. Voices grow and manifest in two angelic cries that must be heard and visualized, that must be taken from abyss, must be accepted, must be kissed with lips that bleed from too much speech. Tongues that tremble from beseeched epiphanies that force their will and will be heard and will be said and will be seen and will be shared. Read, the angel cries his will. Speak, give forth, let pages fill. Enliven worlds and shine with that same light which breathes from heaven's height. When voices speak, hear. When voices call, draw near. With voices deep within your chest, let voices grow and manifest, or sit with voices as your prize, cursed with words that fill your eyes, that beat your chest, that pin your soul, stay paralyzed from so much known but dare not share, a world that rests in you alone, a whole world's weight for you to bear. Thank you very much. So how did John got killed today? I don't know if you cheer that, or if you don't, and I'm genuinely kind of puzzled about that. So far, in the kind of, everything that's happened since 9/11 has been this massive, epic deal, where I've kind of known where I stand. And suddenly today, I don't know where I stand. I think that this poem is kind of relevant to this confusion, perhaps. It's called Clash. There has, there have nots. There has, but will not. The woods, but could not. The coulds. But would not. The has, think not. The thinks, but ask not. The asks that know not, the knows that care, the tongue that speaks not, but voice that's heard not, the voice that's heard not, but speech that tells not. Apparent standoffs between us and rest of the world that thinks not in terms of suitors, so the lies we spread not, of foreign despots, the wish to kin also must be killed off. The heads that bow, the hands that shake not, when holding slingshots, when facing the gunshot. The view that's changed not from colonial plots, civilizing dark flocks to get what they've got. The books that teach not, each phrase anew not, claim cultures move not, and stand as fixed blocks. And the books that flow past borders and won't stop, make ours who once were people we knew not. A choice we've all got, be held or hold off. Embrace what's known not, knowing we know not, or claim we share not, and so we grow not. What's different, trust not, and let it be not. There has to happen. There has but will not. The ones that call shots, the ones that get shot. That is the only clash of civilizations. Thank you. So I'm originally from Lancashire, and spent a lot of time in Manchester, because it's quite close to where I lived, which was university as well. And if any of you know Manchester and live there, then you'll know what happens on Eid. Eid's a Muslim festival. Does anybody know Manchester? Does anybody know what I'm talking about? Wimslow Road on Eid?
Yeah.
Yeah? Okay, great. She knows. So this poem is for you. It's kind of, right, so like what happens, well, what used to happen when I was younger, is on Eid we hire cars. This has nothing to do with Quran. It has nothing to do with Islam. It's just, I don't know why. But Eid meant we hired cars, and they had to be the best cars you could get. So we'd be saving up all year to be able to hire some really flash cars for one night. And then we'd drive them to Wimslow Road, and we'd play loud music, and we'd kind of just take over that road. And the cars would just drive from one end to the end, the other end, and then they'd turn around and they'd come back again. And they'd do that till 6 in the morning. It was, believe it or not, amazing. It was an amazing atmosphere. It was kind of a cross between a riot and a street party. There was another riot place there as well. And sometimes things did get messy. Anyway, people would raise flags, and the flag bit, the cars bit, didn't bother me. All the music, all the right things. But the flags bit was weird. So I wrote a poem. You ask why the minority Englishman wears the flag of the country he's never known. Seldom beams. Why the minority Englishman, the brown, ethnic, the Asian Englishman, wraps around his English rear body with English nourished limbs. The flag of another. Why is a young Asian, brown, ethnic, British Muslim, minority Englishman parades the flag of a distant other like a cape, as though worn with fantasies of flight? You ask. I'll explain what I can. A divine command, grace, laced the land with lamps of flickering latent faith. Day's sedate, blessed state, enlivened night's expansive with its supplicates, devoid of weight. For 30 days and 30 nights, till Earth's rotation met with moon's revealing flight and expanse retreating. and air regained to it. As 1,001 insecurities retold their tired tales on intently labored pages. Glistening, as now whispering transgressors deceive with flickering inadequacies. Inadequately forced to fit, reformed, relit, and suddenly familiar again, like crossed words that shouldn't be. Comfortable again, like unanswered questions that shouldn't be. Like attracts like, and 1,000 separate flickers held together burn bright. Between familiar sights, between neon lights, a gathering known of the knowing of those who know not to make known, those who know will know. A drop, a puddle, a pool, from pool a moving trickle of cars, from trickle to stream, the stream breaks seams and floods, a crashing river of cars, and floods, a crashing river of cars, and pours a gushing heap of cars, discharged with youth's audacious proclamations of presence, violent in its naivety. Brazen declarations declaring existence, flares of existence, for one night only, undenied, for this night only, underlined, drums break beats. The streets are ours. Roars crack deep. The streets are ours. And 1,000 separate splinters of the previously silent whole synchronized through a riotous outpouring of questions dance through feet. The streets are ours. Tear concrete, the streets are ours. Gather together, brothers in confusion. Together, project your own premonitions. Together, gather in darkness, shrouded with blaze. Scream in streets, the streets are ours. Scream in streets, these screams are ours. Previously contained by the length of an arm, taut with derision, ensured division. Now snap it with rage. Scream in the streets. These screams are ours. A universe to themselves. Self-orbiting swarms of 1,001 screaming voids. Self-sustaining storms. Hurling themselves into cloud, into dispersion, into cloud. From the gravity of their own audacity, a plague of assertion. Self-determined, self-enforced, self-fulfilled without laws of land or sky, no longer even God's face this, all that remains sacred is the rage. Sirens are festive lights, our soundtrack to festive nights, as rude boys with rude noise descend for festive fights. The new moon's decreed it, deprived now we need it, replenishment sought worth 30 days and 30 nights. Devils unleashed. But so are the henchmen. Neon clad on the walls where they were none. Manifesting unseen borders they encroach on and hold in to hold on, pressing in the more they're pressed upon. And in response to repression, pressure grows strong, roars on, screams spew song, and silent symbols are clutched upon, contesting the enforcer's force. Unheard themselves, uncurled from shells, unformed. In resistance to enforced expectations, unfurl symbols of self-definition. Unfurl your flag. Zindabad, where no blue or red exists to clash with your brand. Zindabad, mask the gaping holes of yourselves, voids of ourselves. Zindabad, with the flag of a country we've never known. Zindabad, outside of our own fantasies. Zindabad, Pakistan. Pakistan, Zindabad. Pakistan, Zindabad. Pakistan, Zindabad. Why does the British-born, English-reared, brown, ethnic, British Muslim, Asian minority Englishman raise, drape, wear the flag of another distant other US? I can only explain what I can explain. Though the truth is, I seldom even wonder why those that look like me raise a Pakistani flag. Though most that look like me were never Pakistani British. And only know the place from a Pakistani dad who left in 1974. I can only explain what I can explain. But the truth is, at times, I also wonder why it's never the Union Jack. Thank you. First of all, God, I'm going to start again, because I know some of you don't believe in God, but that's okay. By law, I believe something wrong. But just pretend or something. Dust. Fire. It's a tale of eternity. First of all, God, and God said, be, so it was, and it is, but to who did he speak? To you or me? Neither and either. He spoke to we, see, we were there, always have been, always have seen, from the serene to the not so, and all that was in between. Yet to share that we were there. In our root manifestation, the primary creation, the first that was, the last that will, and until this realization will be fulfilled, this crazy rancor shall rant, dust, a humble magnificence, an unnoticed beauty, self-assured, silent bearer of eternal truths and eternal original secrets. Bad. Big. Bigger. And that mighty thunderous discharge thrust out into newborn space, free-born dust, filling and spilling its packets and pockets of space and time like a desert sandstorm for a while. Then that initial rage and ferocity cooled and turned to potato, to marvel at the magic of creating. A world full of dust was about to be formed, the swarms of these tiny, insignificant, ineloquent particles joined together from their own inherent attraction, and thus from dust, stars did form, and hence planets. Stardust, fire, it's the tale of entire entirety. Of the genesis, this just the surface is. Upon which I'll scratch on further. Human, the best of creation. Powerful, capable, potential for greater things, for nobler things, to soar through skies with inspired wings, to venture high and dare to bring destiny to his or her own whim. Human, the best of creation. Powerful, capable, potential for greater things, but gold nor silver brought forth this wonder. He created him with dust. Said to him, be it he was. And thus, with dust, our cycle completes. That from which the stars and planets were born gave rise to human form. A system entwined and linked that binds us all together at all levels, extra, intra, within, and without. No one life, therefore, greater than another. No one life more worthy, more deserving, no other. Thank you. This was one of my first poems. It's called Bob Bow. I think, you know, for most poets who write poems, you know it. It might not be your first, you know, it might be later, but you realise that, yeah, actually, this is it, this is what I'm doing. I'm going to write poems. And Bob Bow, I think, was for me, that poem. And I thought, yeah, I'm going to write poems, man. So, it's been a bit of a journey, because now, you know, the poem Bob Bow is about, well, let me tell you the day when the earth stood still. The birds stopped mid-flight and the sun felt a chill. The planet's death revolved, winds made tranquil, the oceans even rose as her eyes did fill. A day of human suffering that lacks unseen, aftermath that will remain till the day of reckoning. In a sunk soul slain with the force of hurricane and the truth made sick by no want of questioning. Now, once upon a time, ain't how this story goes, and the land of which we talk ain't as far as we told. It's a recent event, not no story of old, 31 years of injustice. Still a case not closed. A terrorist in our midst is a hypothesis put to. An act of evil somebody's ain't too far from the truth, but the villain we're dealing with ain't Arab or Pashtun, ain't no bombs involved, or towers times two. See, the terrorist corporate, so the motive's quite clear. Ain't no honour involved, just a hungry profiteer. Let me cut to the chase and tell you all quite straight. Hobart is a theme, we ain't leaving till you're here. On the 3rd of December, 1984, midnight struck the clock, announcing death at the door. And like a thief in the night, with indiscriminate sight, a beast was unleashed from the white man's venture. Now, race ain't an issue, so relax now, you pet. I ain't here to cause trouble, the intolerance left. But the picture that I paint from the next viewpoint, thousands of Indians maimed and thousands dead. So the phrase that I use is to benefit you. From the victim standpoint, how we'll see this issue. Let's recourse back from our sensitive trip and deal with the matter which I set out to do. A chemical factory where the scene was set. Union carbides, how the placards were read. A leak that could prevent safety measures and spend caused a poison cloud to be shot out and spread. People dying still today and tomorrow. But anyway, if the D word's too much for you to even hear, then you'd rather a chat about Santa and reindeer than I hate to offend those sensitive ears. But you all can walk away or confront your inner fears. What I'm saying is all true. It's what money can do. That I can't explain the green. Those people had a part too. Those suits and those ties and those smiles so wry. They're the cause of this cry. Yet we try to deny that we breed terrorists in a deceitful guise. Dignified handshakes with a fist full of lies. So please let me know that defies my belief how the value of the people seems dependent on their creed. Yes, genocide seemed a worthy price to pay for a little bit of profit and a Westerner's delay. Thank you.
And just to end, before stars in the sky, before moon in the night, before day and the sun, when beginnings begun, before good, before bad, before joy became sad, before love brought us light, before light brought us sight, before right, before wrong, before sound turned to song, before heaven and hell, before hopes ever fell, before curtains were raised, before secrets were laid, before symbols arranged, before promises made, before bricks made of dust dare to claim that entrusted between them they held that which mountains repelled, before one became two became few, before few even knew what the truth was of you, only 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 you, before stars and the sky, before moon and the night, before day and the sun, when beginnings begun, before good, before bad, before joy became sad, before love brought us light, before light brought us sight, before right, before wrong, before sound turned to song, before heaven and hell, before hopes ever fell, before
before curtains were raised, before secrets were laid, before symbols arranged, before promises made, before one became two, before two became few, before few even knew what the truth was of you. Only you, 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 only you.